Differential thermostatic control is the best way to ensure net heat gain from the sun. Some controllers not only regulate heat flow, but they also monitor collector and storage temperatures. Some controllers use multiple relays that control pumps and electronic valves. And some controllers use controls for both the differential on and differential off settings. All of these things are fine, but remember, the most important job of any solar controller involves the activation of a pump when heat is available for collection. For this reason, I've developed a rugged, basic differential controller that responds to heat availability.
Okay, now that we understand how thermistors work to sense a differential in temperature, let's install them inside this basic differential controller, and we'll see if we can not only monitor the heat that's available, but also control a pump. That green light, when that green light is on, it indicates that the pump is on. Now, we'll get into that just a little later. But I'm going to set, this is a differential pot adjustment, and it tells you at what point the pump should come on or the pump should come off. The differential on and differential off temperatures are integrated into one adjustment. Anyway, so we have two probes. This probe senses the collector temperature, and this probe senses the storage temperature. They're both identical. It's just that I'm using different colored wires to distinguish them. That's all. Anyway, so right now, both probes are at the same temperature. And if you look at the red LED that indicates the amount of heat that's available, it's the amount of heat that's available right now is zero because the red LED isn't glowing. It's going to glow more intensely as more heat becomes available. So we'll add heat to the collector probe, and you'll see that the LED is starting to glow as heat is made available, and the intensity of it will increase as the heat increases. And eventually you can see the green LED comes on, indicating that the pump is on. Now, as the collector temperature cools down, or as the heat storage temperature heats up, the intensity of the light will go down, which indicates that there's less and less heat available. When there's no heat available, the pump will come off. I'm going to add a little heat to the storage tank. Okay, so right now the voltage at the common junction is about 2.5 volts, and at that point the pump comes off. And we can adjust that point right here with the differential pot adjustment. Now, if we want the pump to come on at a very low temperature, as a matter of fact, a temperature differential that's actually less than zero, we can turn this pot totally counterclockwise. This is mostly for testing, just to see if your pump is working. You normally wouldn't set it that low. Normally it would be set just about halfway. But sometimes if you're going on vacation or something, you might want to set this differential pot totally clockwise. This will conserve power, and also it'll only turn the pump on when the collector gets very hot compared to the temperature of the storage tank. Okay, now if we apply heat, it's not going to come on right away. We're heating up the collector probe. You can see it's glowing pretty brightly, but the pump still isn't on. It has to glow very brightly, and the heat that's available has to be very intense before the pump finally comes on. And there. Now the pump comes on, and that's at a differential temperature of maybe 25 degrees. Okay, so the collector is 25 degrees hotter than the storage tank temperature. Now, if we wait long enough, the collector probe will cool down and the pump comes off. But you can see there's still heat that's available. But maybe we don't want to collect that much heat if we're on vacation or for some reason. Anyway, there's a great adjustment range, and the range between the collector being on, I'm sorry, the pump, the range between the pump being on and the pump being off is just about 12 degrees. But you can set the temperature at which the pump comes on with this differential pot adjustment. Anyway, that's the basic idea of the basic differential controller. Last but not least, we have the photovoltaic controller, or the PV controller. I call it that because it was designed to work in harmony with photovoltaic systems. As you know, when the pump first comes on in dim light, it draws a lot of current, and the voltage supply to the differential controller drops so low that in many cases the controller itself won't work properly. Anyway, this controller will work at very low voltages. At any rate, it's other than that, it's pretty similar to the basic differential controller. It's in an enclosed fixture. So we're all set up. We have our pot. This is, I call it the differential pot adjustment. So right now, the differential temperature is set at zero. So in other words, the temperature difference between collector and storage is, they're both the same temperature. There's no difference in temperature, so you wouldn't expect the pump to come on, and it's not on. Now, if we increase this, you can see the red LED starting to glow at about 5 degrees or so. And if we continue to increase the differential, it glows more and more brightly. And eventually, it should turn on the pump. And it does. It turns the pump on. Right now, it's turning the pump on at about a differential of 15 degrees. Now, we can adjust the point at which it turns the pump on with this differential adjustment. Okay, let's turn this down a little. So, right now, the differential at which it will come on is about 10 degrees, and it'll go off at about 2 degrees. And this is something that you can adjust yourself. If we turn this up all the way, it's going to take a lot more heat to turn the pump on. We're at 10 degrees, 15 degrees, 20 degrees. All right, now it's 22 degrees before the pump comes on, and it will come off at 14 degrees. Now, that's a very high differential. You'd only use that setting like if you're going on vacation or you want to conserve a lot of power. And this might be an option for photovoltaic controllers under normal use. If you have a very small photovoltaic panel and you don't want to use too much power. Anyway, so this is the basic idea of the differential controller with the red heat indicator lamp that indicates the amount of heat that's available. Okay, well, thanks again for your time. May all your days be sunny.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds, because you're mine, I walk the line. I find it very, very easy to be true. I find myself alone when each day is through. Yes, I'll admit that I'm a fool for you, because you're mine, I walk the line. As sure as night is dark and day is light, I keep you on my mind both day and night. And happiness I've known proves that it's right, because you're mine, I walk the line. You've got a way to keep me on your side. You give me cause for love that I can't hide. For you I know I'd even try to turn the tide, because you're mine, I walk the line. I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tie that binds, because you're mine, I walk the line, because you're mine.